Welcome to Dinolift. Today we have the two trailer mounted lifts, the DINO 52XT and XTB, specifically targeted for the North American market. And I'm going to walk you through the specifications of the machines and why these two lifts would be the perfect fit for your rental fleet and what kind of features you can expect on the lifts. So basically what we're talking about are two different lifts that share the same platform. We have a gas-powered 52XT and the 52XTB then fully battery-powered. The XT version weighs in at 4,430 pounds and the battery version slightly more at 4,800 pounds. Both lifts, they have the same boom configuration with the safe working load of 475 pounds and they both have 29 feet 10 inches of horizontal reach and 52 feet of working height. So let's start.
Let's dive into the details, starting with the boom configuration, which on this size class is a little bit unique for Dinolift. So we are using a three-stage telescopic upper boom because of the total transport length, which is 20 feet and 10 inches, which is the shortest in this height class for towable lifts. The width is 5 feet 11 inches, and something to note here specifically when it comes to the boom design or articulation design, the scissor pack or articulation here in back actually is a vertical riser. What it does is when you're lifting the articulation, it doesn't affect the horizontal location of the basket. So when you raise the articulation, it's individually raised, not affecting where the basket is in relation to the turret. Now for the towing speeds and stability, majority of the heavy weight components are actually located here in the back of the machine, meaning the turret, the outriggers, the engines, the articulating arms, majority of the boom. And having those heavy components on top of the axle or near the axle actually makes the lift very stable to tow, because any weight that is further away from the axle would have a turning moment and affecting the stability or the towing stability. Something else to note from the back of the machine is that the engine, whether it's the electric or the gas engine, that's sitting behind the machine, protected from the towing vehicle or the spray from the towing vehicle, and sits under the covers. Something else to note from this side of the machine is the front outriggers, which have a protective film here in the front to protect them, the paint, from the stone chips from the towing vehicle. Something else to notify here, also a standard feature on both of the 52 machines, is the 180 degree hydraulic basket rotation, which is a standard feature. What we have is a extension cylinder here on top of the boom rather than sitting underneath, which makes the operator easy to see the cylinder. If it was mounted underneath, it would be more prone for possible damage. And also the catch racks for electrics or hydraulics going to the basket, they are all mounted inside the boom. That's also basically just to protect them and reduce the possibility for damaging those, again causing possible downtime for the units. At the back of the extension cylinder, there's a damping mechanism here in the back. So when the boom is extracted towards the maximum horizontal position, basically it creates a bending moment for the extension cylinder as well. But now we have two support points here in front. And basically the damper at the back of the extension cylinder creates or reduces the wear on these seals and O-rings here in the front of the cylinder, extending its lifetime. And again, reducing possible maintenance point.
Now we are looking at the details on the tongue of the lift. So we have the surge brake system on this trailer. There's a manual handbrake. Of course, the connector to the vehicle lighting. We have a 2-inch ball type hitch. Also, of course, the safety change, the breakaway cable, and then specifically, again, developed by the feedback in the rental companies, we have the double jockey wheel, making the lift actually very well operable in rougher terrain lawns, together with the drive system. Moving on to the details about the basket. So as standard, we have the easy entry gate, meaning every two-man basket comes with the stairs that actually close or lock the gate in place. And what we mean by the easy entry gate is actually you will open it, it's self-closing. We don't use a drop-down bar on the basket because that makes life more difficult when you're carrying tools, you're wearing your harness and your safety gear. And in that addition to the gate itself, we have two spots here to grab onto. Again, adding safety, and the stairs are covered with this non-slip tape. All the baskets come standard with two 110 volt sockets and also a standard USB charging for your phones. Also standard in every basket is the cup or tool holder here, and a nice feature for rental companies to clean the baskets after they've been out on rent is your cleaning hatch. Also the basket and the controls have a lockable cover on them for to not have like water or snow getting in there when parked. Also the lock kind of like acts of course as a means to reduce the possibility for wrongful use of the machine. Somebody who's not familiarized with the lift or trained to operate. So the drive system, that's something that all the Dino trailer mounted lifts have as standard. We've found out from the customers, the rental companies and customers, the operators, that when you are actually taking a lift, let's say for a painting job or taking down trees, cleaning the gutters, whatever, for the most part, all of those are not accessible from the front of the house. And if you have a narrow path to the backyards, the drive system is actually the most beneficial way to get there. So the operation or engaging the drive system is manual. You engage the Robson wheel, and then there's two options to be operating the controls. So what we have also as standard is a cable remote for the drive system, including a kill switch. And having this as a standard feature basically gives anybody operating the drive system like a clear view around the machine if there are any obstacles on the way, something to be looking out for. And the controller is stored here in a lockable box as well. Here at the back of the machine, we have the engine compartment, again under lockable covers. And in this case, we're talking about the 52XT, the gas engine version. Let's say for the ease of use, the engine itself can be moved from the stowed position to make the refueling easier. Regarding the long expected lifetime of the machine in the rental fleets, I think there's a couple points to take a note. One of the things is the wiring harness, not just for the electrics of the lift, but also for the lighting for the roads. So all of these wiring harnesses are well covered within these protections, well mounted on the frame as well. Another thing to point out here is that while the outriggers are in their stowed position, the extension cylinders for the outriggers, they actually mounted horizontally. They are protected inside the frame from the elements coming from the towing vehicle. And then when you lower the outriggers, they do have aluminum protective covers on them to protect them from falling objects. Now, regarding the turret, DINOs, both 52XTB and XTs, they are unique in sense of they both have 360 degrees continuous rotation as standard. Specifically, what it means is, of course, the operator can start their job on one location, they can turn around on the other side, they might want to do something else or there, if we're talking about tree care or stuff like that, and they can return to the base using the shortest distance. You don't have to rotate back the same way that you started. In terms of the continuous rotation, one of the cool features of the 52s are that even though if you are turned 90 degrees from the tow bar, the tail of the boom actually will never go past the outrigger footprint. So even though if you are parked close to the wall or a tree or cars, whatever, you know that as long as you've set your outriggers down, the turret will not go past the outrigger footprint. Regarding the lower control of the machine, you have the main power switch, obviously a selector for the off lower controls or upper controls, voltage, hour meter, battery indicator, in this case as this the XTB model. You have the dead man switch to operate the toggle switches for the boot movements while you're operating from the lower controls. A unique feature based on the feedback from rental again is the emergency stop button actually has a LED on it. If it's on, if the LED is on, it means that none of the emergency stops are activated. If it's off, it means that at least one of them are engaged. That's actually a very common reason for a call from the rental customer. Then you have a green indication that your outriggers are set correctly with sufficient pressure on them. You can operate the drive system from the lower controls as well if you don't want to use the remote. And to top it all, you have a QR code that takes you to YouTube to watch a quick start video of the operation of the lift. operating the outriggers, standard is these manual hydraulic levers with a dead man switch right next to them. And optionally, both lifts can be equipped with automatic leveling as well. Now, thinking about the ownership of the 52 in your rental fleet, all the DINOs come nowadays standard with the My DINO telematics service, which means that you have visibility over your assets in terms of location, hours. You can monitor some of the typical operator cases, like not having sufficient pressure on outriggers. You can see some of the load cases on the boom, and that kind of stuff. In addition to that, for the security and of course the low total cost of ownership, the 52s come with an extended 3-year warranty as standard nowadays, plus a 5-year warranty for the structural parts. So I think time to wrap up. Thanks for watching, and hope to hear from you soon.